Is it my turn?
Yeah.
Hello, YouTube. Baseball Card Junkies TV here. Eric, Nate. We have another episode for you here. We're just gonna have a little discussion for you guys. Just as far as who we think are gonna hit those career milestones, 500 home runs, 3,000 hits.
Yes.
Etc.
That are currently playing now, obviously, because guys that are terrible.
Right. Like guys that we think are definitely going to do it, and then guys that we think will, have a real shot at it, and then also guys that we think that, you should probably look at investing in if you haven't already, that are way, way off from doing it, but will probably do it.
Alright. So what do you want to start with, 3,000 hits?
Sure, we can start with 3,000 hits. That sounds good to me.
Alright. So, there are two players that are going to get to 3,000 hits in the next 2 years. In 2017, I'm thinking that Adrian Beltre is going to get to 3,000 hits. Right, as of right now, he's 118 hits shy of 3,000 hits. And this year already, he's almost got that many hits. So, between wrapping up this year, which he'll probably get, 30 more hits, you think?
Yeah, he's going to end up over 2,900 hits.
He'll end up this year with over 2,900 hits, and then he should wrap that up next year. And I don't see why he wouldn't be a starter next year. It's not like Ichiro this year where he had to get 65 hits. It's like a fourth outfielder and a pinch hitter.
Beltre is still a solid defensive player.
Yep.
Maybe not the gold glover that he used to be, but still very solid at third base.
Yep.
Plus, he can probably play first and DH if necessary.
Yep.
He's only 37 years old, so he's still got a couple years at least.
Yeah.
And then Albert Pujols.
Yes, he is.
He's at 2774 right now.
Okay, so he needs 226 hits.
Yeah, 226.
So I'm thinking 2018 he'll get his 3,000th hit. He's still going to start because he's got that monster contract.
He's a DH now.
Yeah,
he's got the monster contract.
And I actually, we talked about in our last video, obviously he'll get the 600 homers.
Yeah.
And a very, 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 very outside shot
at
700. But I don't see him getting the 700, but I do see him easily getting the 600.
Yeah. I'd say for Pujols, for me, with the 700 number, I would love to see him hit it. But he's one of those guys that I think this when we were talking, don't be surprised if he does, don't be surprised if he doesn't.
And same thing with his age, don't be surprised if he's older.
Yeah, don't be surprised if he's actually 50 years old.
Or don't be surprised if he's only 45.
Yeah. So, another guy I think is definitely in the 3,000 hit comp. Sorry, I'm looking down, I have some statistics up on my phone. Miguel Cabrera. He's only 33 years old, he's currently at 2,453 hits.
You I'm figure say,
five more years of 140 hits?
I don't know. I mean, that's...
I think he's definitely got a good shot at
it. That's one of those, I'd say, I'd give him... I could easily see him petering out at around 2,800 hits.
I think his health is the only thing
that's what I'm
saying. Issue.
Yeah, I can see him.
He's had a lot of injuries the last few seasons.
Yeah. I can't see it. I'd be surprised. I could see him doing it, but I'd be surprised if he got the 3,000 hits. So let's just put it that way.
Okay, another don't be surprised if he does. Don't be surprised if he does. Because he definitely has, he's a lot like Pujols. He has that very barrel-chested frame up top. Yeah. So.
You know, it's funny, man. You look at his rookie pose. That guy was like thin, like a pole.
He definitely got big.
But his rookie career is probably 18 years old, so what do you expect from that
world? But again, I think Miguel Cabrera, again, health being a concern, has a shot of doing it.
Small shot.
And then I think that's pretty much it for 3,000 hits.
Except, let's go back to the young players.
Young players,
Mike Trout.
Mike Trout, I think, is probably reasonably the only guy right now that has a shot of doing it.
Yeah,
Nolan Arenado.
Nolan
depending on if he plays long enough. Yeah. He's in Colorado. But I think if you wanted to pick a guy who was definitely going to do it, Mike Trout was the only guy that's in that conversation.
Well, within the guys that are 25 years or younger.
Yeah, in that range.
Yeah, in that range. Yeah.
I think Anthony Rizzo, if he plays long enough, he puts
a sleeper.
He puts up the hit numbers that he could do it.
Yeah, he's definitely a sleeper for that. But
who knows? I just don't think there's a lot of guys that they're just, you know, helping issues now more than I remember it being 10 years ago.
Why should they play long enough?
And, with pitching now, you look at last year, Bryce Harper with his numbers.
Yeah.
Now nobody's pitching to him.
Yeah.
So you're going to have that kind of be an issue. You know,
well, they're starting to pitch to him a little more because he's striking out a lot. I mean, when the Giants played that series against Washington, they weren't pitching around Bryce Harper really at all.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Yeah, when you look at Madden,
he struck out a lot too.
Yeah. So he could get. I mean, if he could repeat last year, at least on the hits, in the hits column, he's got a chance of 3,000 hits.
Well, because he's so damn young.
He's 22 years old.
22 years old.
So he could get there, but he's so inconsistent.
Yeah.
I don't even know. I don't even like bringing him back in that column right now.
Harper is an anomaly.
Yeah, so
one good year, one bad year. Almost like a pitcher.
Yeah, exactly.
You usually don't see that from position.
Like last year he hit 340. 42 home runs?
Yeah, I can't remember.
Something like that.
Yeah.
And 99 RBIs. This year he's hitting 240. A whole 100 points, like 105 points lower. He's got 22 home runs. And only like 50-something or 60-something.
Yeah, still good numbers.
But he's leading the league in walks.
Yeah.
So 500 home runs.
All right, so 500 home runs.
Guys, yes. That will probably definitely get there. I think Miguel Cabrera.
Yeah, I mean, you're figuring if he's 33 now.
33, and he has 434 home runs.
So, what's that, 66 homers away? Or no? Yeah, 66 homers. So,
3 more years of 32 home runs.
He's not going to hit. No, 66 homers, that would be like 3 more years of 22 homers.
Yeah.
So he can,
he's going to get there.
He's going to get there.
He's going to get there.
Yeah.
Even if it takes him 6 more years, he's going to get there.
He's just got to stay healthy. That's the main thing.
He has a better shot of getting 500 home runs than 3,000.
Yep.
And then that's kind of, Jose Bautista. He's kind of, he's sitting at 301 right now. He's 35 years old.
Yeah, no, that's 200.
He can play 5 more years and hit 40 home runs a season. He's got it!
Yeah, Bautista, his power came on too late. That's a problem. His power came on too late.
Yeah, I think more of an issue that he didn't become a starter until late.
Yeah, so I don't see Bautista. He's still like 43 or something.
Yeah, and he doesn't think he's going to. I think he's going to. Edwin Encarnacion.
And what's he at?
He's at 299 right now. He's 33 years old. He's been averaging around 30.
Yeah, but right now you got to remember he's
in
the prime of his career.
He can extend that prime 4 more years. He's a DH. I think he's
100. You said 301.
Yo, he's 201 away.
I don't see it, but hey, Eric,
I'm like a baseball genius.
You're more optimistic than me. We'll have to go look back at this 5 years from now.
Yeah,
and laugh at ourselves to see our prediction.
So I think he's he's a don't be surprised if he does. Don't be surprised if he doesn't.
Yeah. Definitely on the radar.
Yeah.
And then there's a couple of guys with 400 homers that are currently playing. That's Beltre and Beltrum. And I don't think either one of them, I don't think are going to get to 500. They're both around 430.
430 for Beltre and 415 for Beltrum.
I don't think either one
Beltrum
of them.
Beltrum won't do it. He's 39 years old.
Yeah.
Beltre again, 37 years old. Well, I got 2 or 3 more years. He'd have to repeat some of his years in
these. These guys are right now, at this point in their career, are gonna be 20 like this year.
Yeah.
So there's no way that they're gonna get to 500.
Yeah.
In my opinion, I don't see how they can get to reach that milestone.
Yeah.
Among the younger players, though,
I think we have the same names in the conversation. Mike Trout.
Yep.
Chris Bryant.
Yep.
Anthony Rizzo.
Yep.
Nolan Arenado.
Yes, he just got to 100. How old is Arenado?
He's like 24, 25.
Yeah, I mean, 96. Yeah, he's
going to get there. I think Carlos Gonzalez, he's at 199. He is 27 years old. Again, we got that inconsistency issue with him and the health issues. He's out right now.
Yeah, and how long is he going to be playing in Colorado? That's the question.
Left-handed hitter in Colorado and pick up some home runs pretty quick.
I don't know. I don't see him doing it, but I do see Nolan Arenado. That guy's just a freaking stud.
Yeah, definitely worth.
Trout, Harper, and Bryant. All three of those guys. It's like one of those things where they could either be a 300 home run guy or a 600 home run. They're going to be somewhere within there. You just don't know until their career progresses. All three of them have a shot. They all have a shot.
As much as I'd like to see Harper get the 500 home run, because I have so much invested in him right now, I think he's going to be like a 425, 450.
Interesting prediction. He's only 22. I see him hit 500 home runs.
He's either going to hit 40 home runs or he's going to hit 25 home runs.
I see him. But we'll see. Any other young players? Middle career players to hit the 500 home runs?
Nelson Cruz is too old. He's 37 years old.
Yeah, 36
years old.
What is he at, like 3?
He's not even over 300 yet.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Again, he's another guy like Bautista. He just did not become an everyday starter until really late in his career.
Yeah.
But these guys are still, like, I still have Nelson Cruz, Jose Bautista. They're still in my PC. They're going to be guys that are worth money.
They're fan favorites.
Yeah, they're fan favorites. They're going to be guys that are always going to hold some value to somebody.
They're always going to like have 1 or 2 years where they're in the top five in the MVP voting. Those type of players, fan favorites. I mean, like a lot of the players were anticipating. Like if you go back and you look at Will Clark, that guy was like a lock for 500 homers and a Hall of Fame career in his first like 4 or 5 seasons, and he petered out at like a little over 300 home runs. And, I mean, he's not even close to being a Hall of Fame.
He
was like
240.
Yeah, I mean, so you just never know where people's careers are going to go.
But yeah, and another guy like Albert Bell is another one of them. And he was like, this guy's going to hit 500 home runs. He
was like, something.
304.
304?
Yeah.
Damn.
He was low.
Yeah, well, he had injury problems, kind of like Prince Fielder. As you guys know, he retired today. So, kind of a shame to see. He would have hit 500 homers if he didn't have that neck problem. Yeah. That guy would. He definitely could have done it.
And then so obviously Trout, Arenado, who else did we say?
Harper, and Bryant.
Bryant, and Rizzo. Maybe Rizzo.
Those are the young guys that have a show.
Yeah.
I would have put like players like McCutcheon in there a couple of years ago. What the hell happened to McCutcheon? He's kind of doing like what Will Clark's career did, you know? So, or like a Don Mattingly. That's another guy. That guy looked like a shoo-in for the Hall of Fame, but really his prime was like about 4 or 5 years, and then he just kind of was done, you know? So you just never know where players' careers. It's just really interesting. Collecting for over 30 years, it's just really interesting to see what players kind of reach these milestones and then which ones just kind of peter out. And then there's always those sleepers like
well, a guy that you didn't think was going to do nearly as good as he did, Torrey Hunter.
Yeah,
like he was another guy. He had like over 2,500 hits and like almost 400 home runs.
He's kind of a sleeper, but I mean, he never came close to those milestones, really. I mean, really, 500 hits and 100 home runs. Not really that close. But like a sleeper, man, Beltre, that guy is a freaking sleeper for 3,000 hits. Where the hell did he come from? I wasn't even thinking about him until a couple of months ago. I saw some guy on YouTube talking about he was getting his rookie card because he's, about to reach these milestones. I'm like, what? So, It's just funny how some guys, you're thinking, oh, they're this, and they're going to do this, and they just don't do it. And then some guys that just are sleepers, and by the time they retire, you're like, whoa, where did that come from?
Yeah.
So it's just interesting how careers go.
Then I think 300 wins for pitching. This one's really easy. Nobody's going to do it.
Yeah, that one's pretty
zero. I think we've talked about this a couple times. Clayton Kershaw is your best bet.
And he's not healthy this year.
He's not healthy this year. But he's under 30. I don't know the exact age.
I think it's still. I mean, think about it. If Clayton Kershaw, 28 years old, wraps up this year, he'll be 29 next year. That means he'd have to pitch till he's 39 and average, how many wins does he have?
He'd have to average like 17 or 18.
17 or 18 wins a year for the next 10 years? Is that going to happen?
No.
Madison Bumgarner, he just got his 100th win earlier this year. And he's about 28.
About the same age.
So for him to get to 300 wins, he'd have to average 20 wins a year for the next 10 years, and that guy's a fucking stud. There's no way he's ever going to get the 300 wins. So it's a bullpen game now. Six innings, I mean, if you get six innings out of your starter, the manager's like, you know, it's a six-inning game, so there's a lot of bullpen decisions now. So it'll be interesting to see what the requirements for the Hall of Fame for this era of pitcher are going to be, because it's going to be a lot different than they were in the 80s and 90s and the early 2000s.
They have to hold them up to the Pedro Martinez model.
Yeah, well, Pedro was like 220 wins.
220 wins.
Yeah.
Like a 2.73 ERA.
But he dominated. He dominated for a while. He didn't just dominate. I mean, he dominated for a while.
Kershaw has 3 Cy Youngs?
3, yeah.
So it's pretty dominant.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, as far as, but, you know, there's going to be guys that, again, are going to be those fan favorite guys and will hold value next Scherzer.
Yeah, he won't hit. There's no way he's going to hit.
He's not going to hit 300.
Maybe 200.
He might hit 200.
Yeah.
But he's going to be.
I think 250 is going to be the next 300. Like 250, so. People are going to look at 250 for this era of pitcher the way 300 was viewed maybe the generation before.
True.
I mean, it's just,
Or even 200.
God, who could possibly get 300 wins? I can't even think of anyone. And Kershaw is, he's like the Sandy Koufax of this generation. It's a really, really, really tough for him to get the 300. It would be really tough. He can't have any more injury seasons like he has this year.
He does have 11 wins this year.
Yeah, but, I mean, that's 11 wins. I mean, he's dominated this year, and he's going to end up with 11 wins because he's injured. I mean, geez.
And there's some guys that are picking up just as far as, like, cards that people are eating up their cards this year. Jake Arrieta, Steven Strasburg. These are two great pitchers, but they're not going to get any career miles.
Yeah, but Strasburg's, at 15 wins? I mean, think about it. There's, a month and
like
a half 20 left?
To 29 years old.
So you figure he's got, 9-10 more starts? So, I mean, if he gets to 20 wins, that's a great season.
He'll win a Cy Young Award.
Yeah. Well, he should win the Cy Young based on his ERA.
Yeah.
It's not about the wins. I mean, his ERA, his whip, innings pitched, I mean, that's what they look at now. They're not going to look at wins and losses.
Yeah.
Too many decisions in the bullpen, really. I mean, and I think a lot of that has to do with, you know, you're signing these pitchers to $150, $200 million contracts. You don't want their arm to get blown out. So
like Kerry Wood.
You know what? His arm got blown out in that 20-strikeout game. And if any of you guys aren't familiar with that game, go on YouTube and watch that game. It was fucking incredible.
That guy's slider.
Anyway,
that was
devastating. A little side rant on Kerry Wood. That game was fucking incredible. I'll never forget that Kerry Wood game. I remember watching that on ESPN.
I mean, he was clocking his fastball at 97.
Oh, man, he just everything, like his
slider was just
It disappeared. But anyway, but after that, his career was pretty much over.
Yeah, he blew his arm out for a little while.
So anyways, those are our thoughts on Milestones. Maybe they'll give you some ideas of guys to collect, especially some of the guys that are coming up on their Milestones.
Like your sleeper guys. I think Adrian Beltre is probably the guy. If you're going to pick anybody out of here,
yes,
you're going to get his
Adrian
cards.
Beltre, he's
super
great,
cheap.
Great time to pick up his cards. I just picked up a whole bunch of them. And yeah, he's like an Eddie motherfucking Murray, really.
Yeah,
if you think about it.
Played forever. And,
yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, the 3,000 hit, 500 homer, even though I don't think he's going to get the 500, but he'll get 470. He'll be like a Dave Winfield type career, because Winfield, what did he have, 465 homers and a little over 3,000 hits, something like that. That's where he's going to end up at, so hey, that's a good career.
A Stan Musial career.
Exactly.
So, yeah, that's kind of our thoughts.
Yep.
And obviously some of those guys are pretty obvious.
Yeah.
But
we'll see what the young players do. It's always interesting to see these careers play out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's definitely fun. It's an exciting time in baseball right now. We have a lot of young,
a lot of good players. Talent. A lot of young talent. Oh, shizzle.
I don't remember it being this kind of hyped as far as young talent ever since A-Rod. A-Rod, I think, was the last guy I remember there being this much hyped about. Just as far in the hobby.
Yeah.
Howard Pujols.
Pujols.
Those two.
Yeah, then in 2001.
But it's a fun time. So go collect some of those guys. Go buy some Adrian Beltre cards.
Yeah, he's fun.
He's fun to collect. He's fun to watch. Again, we're gonna have a little conversation coming up on steroids.
That's, we just want to do a little bit more research, so
yeah. So we don't sound like we're talking out of our asses.
We did have a hell of a conversation with Taco Bell about it today.
Taco Bell. Yeah, that is true.
All right,
the cornerstone of many a good baseball conversation.
Absolutely.
All right, guys. Well, thanks for watching, and we hope you liked the video and found it at least entertaining, if not educational.
So go out there and collect cards. Have fun.
Have fun.
All right.
Double peace.
Woo!